Hi, and welcome to Vincenzo's Plate. In this episode, we are making crepes cannelloni. I am not a huge fan of classic cannelloni, but if you say Vincenzo's Plate crepes cannelloni, then you make me smile and feel hungry. So what we need to make crepes cannelloni is 400 grams of fresh ricotta cheese, one egg, some parsley, some basil. We need 2 bottles of passata pomodoro, which is the Italian tomato for tomato sauce, some provolone cheese, and then we need some onion, celery. These are 3 cubes of frozen spinach, chopped spinach, 2 carrots, cut in half, some mixed herbs. This is rock salt, extra virgin olive oil, and fresh parmesan. And then we need 2 more ingredients, which is very, very important for this dish: crepes. And the other important ingredient is the bechamel sauce. Let's start from the tomato sauce, because it takes a little bit longer, so we want to start from that. We get a pot about this big. We put about 3-4 tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil. Now we stir the onions, and we wait about a couple of minutes until the onions get brown. We are going to put the tomatoes in there. This is a basic tomato sauce that we're making today. If you make extra, you can just keep it in the fridge and use it later on, and you can add any ingredients that you like in the future. So I mix it with the onions. Now we're going to put the rest. So we start from the parsley. Basil and the carrots, just like this. Now here we have the celery. So what I'm going to do with the celery, just by hands, you just break the top part, because we don't want to use the top part, and we are going to break this in half, just like this. And now we place it inside. Celery is very important for tomato sauce because it gives an amazing taste. You should actually have celery every time you make tomato sauce. Now we put rock salt. Just use rock salt because rock salt, it gives a better taste to the tomato, not too much. And now we finish with the mixed herbs. This is my secret ingredient.
The last ingredient, a glass of water.
Now we cover it with a lid. We're going to cook it for about 40 minutes. Make sure it's medium heat and you stir it every 5 minutes because you don't want the tomato at the bottom to stuck. Now we need to make the filling for the crepes. So we get the ricotta, we just put it in the bowl and we just break it with a fork, like this. Now we need to put the spinach. Make sure you strain the spinach before you use it. You don't need any water left. A little bit of water can ruin everything. So make sure there's not water left. Strain it very, very well. We place it in. This is what you want to see. The white and the green. Now we put a pinch of salt. 2 pinches. And then we're gonna put some cinnamon. I know I didn't tell you before, but this is something I like to put with ricotta. If you don't like it, don't use it. This is cinnamon and I love it. Now we grated some parmesan on top. Like this. And finally, the egg. We need to break the egg and put it in there. Okay, we place the egg in. We just mix very well. Just use a fork. A fork is the best utensil to use. Now our tomato sauce is ready. Oh my god, this smells amazing. I can't wait to have this. Let's start from the crepe. So we get the first crepe. We put it here in the middle. Now we're going to get the ricotta cheese with the spinach and we just put it here. Move it here a little bit. And now we need to roll it. So we need to roll it like this. Make it tight, roll it. So at this point, we need to do this. We roll this, and then we continue rolling. We do this so that when we cook this in the oven, the ricotta doesn't come out. Now we finish the dish like this. We get the cannelloni, but be careful the way you get it. Don't open it. And we put some bechamel sauce underneath, just like this. And then we place them. Now we need to get a tomato sauce. We just put it on top like this, just like that. Just like this. Now we finish the dish with provolone cheese on top. Simply. Now we grate some fresh parmesan, parmigiano on top. Okay. Last touch, we need to make three lines of bechamel. And now we're placing the crepes cannelloni in the oven for about 10 minutes at 180 degrees. Now the crepes cannelloni are ready and we're going to place them in the plate. One at a time, we get it. Oh, they look amazing. We place it in the plate. So this is the nice plate now. We finish the dish with some fresh parmesan. Not much, because we have lots of parmesan on top. And then, basil. We love basil. Just put it here on the side. And now the crepes cannelloni can be enjoyed. Thank you very much for watching my show. I will see you in the next Vincenzo's Plate recipe. E ora si mangia! Vincenzo's Plate.